Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Hot Ticket. I'm Kevin Hornsby for Cox 11. And if you're looking for a great time, a great event to take your family outdoors, we've got it for you. The 87th Annual Hampton Cup Regatta. Here to talk about that with me is Lisa Atkins, the chairperson of this year's event.
Hello.
Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
And Ryan LaFada, the marketing and media manager from City Hampton. Thank you guys for being here. Tell me about this wonderful event. If people like speed and adrenaline, this is for them.
Absolutely. If you're feeling the need for speed, then we promote this as being the best show on H2O. It's our Summer Nationals this year, so we're hoping to have lots and lots of boats out there, 10 different classes of boats, including the Jersey Speed Skiff. And we're keeping our fingers crossed. Maybe we'll get some flat bottoms to come back. We hope.
So when you say Summer Nationals, that's basically the equivalent of the Daytona 500 for NASCAR fans.
Yes.
But for racing.
Yes, it is. And because of that, we hope to draw boats from all over the United States. And we're also hoping that our Canadian friends will come back and play with us this year as well.
Okay. Ryan, how many spectators a year do we usually have at this event?
We generally pull between 30 and 35,000 spectators every year over a 2 or 3 day period. This year, we're racing in 2 days, and we have a Bash at the Bridge on a Friday night. So over the 3 day period, we roughly somewhere between the 30 and 35,000 mark.
So we're going to party all weekend and
all weekend long.
Just outside of Fort Monroe. Let's tell people how to get there and what they can expect.
Yeah, it's actually the East Mercury Bridge is the best viewing spot. And that bridge is going to be closed off to basically traffic that's going across, but there'll be foot traffic. Anybody's welcome to come sit on the bridge and you know, enjoy the show. So that's right where it is. East Mercury Bridge right in front of Fort Monroe. Fort Monroe, of course, is now a national monument and open to the public. So right there, right at the bridge.
So we're having a party Friday night, Bash on the Bridge with XS playing some rock and roll for people. And specifically for Saturday, folks coming out to the event, because it's from 10 to 5, what can they bring?
We're going to have plenty of food vendors out there. We're going to have plenty of drink vendors out there, so they don't even have to worry about water, food. They can purchase everything right there on the bridge.
Okay.
We do have an ABC line that we'll be respecting, so for the frosty adult beverages.
There you go.
But lawn chairs are good. You're welcome to bring umbrellas. There's a limited amount of seating.
Okay.
We'll have some bleachers, but they get kind of hot sometimes.
What about easy-ups? Pop-up tents for the shade?
A few. Yeah. People have set those up in the past.
Okay.
So if they've got them, we're not going to discourage them from putting them up. Yeah, there's not a tremendous amount of place to put them on the bridge, but they can still do that if they'd like.
Well, let's take a look at some pictures and give an idea of what people are going to see out here, because this is high speed. I mean, this is really fast. This is a lot of noise. And there we go, looking at one here.
That's a Jersey Speed Skiff, which is actually one of the most popular classes that we have. And they don't float on the traditional pocket of air like a hydroplane does. That one is, some people just call them the bouncy boats.
Right.
So we expect to have a good contingency of those there. That's a boat. That's a modified boat. Really loud, really fast.
Well, what type of speeds are we approaching here? I mean, this is, do we know how fast these things can go?
If we can, if the water's nice and flat, then yes, some of the boats that will be coming out there are capable of 130, 140 miles an hour.
Wow. Now, for the children, because folks come out, obviously kids get the attention, wants to go elsewhere. You got activities for them as well?
We are going to provide a children's area, and we're hoping to have that down at the foot of the bridge. And I'm hoping to get confirmation on one other thing we're going to have down there for the kids, so I'm not going to let the secret out yet.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. And Ryan, what about just why is this important for the city of Hampton to do something like this?
Well, it's a huge event for us. It's one of the last events, major events of the summer. We have events all the time in Hampton, but it's one of our, it's one of the major events of the summer. This race started in 1926. It's the oldest continuously running hydroplane boat race in the country.
Right.
It's a lot of history. I mean, there's people that have great ties to this in Hampton and throughout the area, and you know, their parents or their grandparents, and it's just a really good family event, and it means a lot to City Hampton for sure.
Encourage people to bring their cameras out.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You can never have too many pictures of a boat race.
Yeah, I can imagine. Video too, I imagine.
Let's
talk about being right outside Fort Monroe, Mill Creek. I mean, open to the public now. People can probably come out and take some great pictures out there, but Phoebus, good parking in that area as well, correct?
Absolutely. Parking in, around the Phoebus area, around the East Mercury Bridge, there should be some parking that you can find.
Okay. And we want to encourage people to go to the website to find out all the information, but what's your favorite part of the race? We have just a few seconds left.
When it's over? No. I just love seeing the boats on the water. There's a couple classes that are out there that literally, if you stand on our bridge and look down towards the boats coming towards the starting line, and when they line up just right, there's nothing like it. You'll get goosebumps.
Well, Lisa and Ryan, I want to thank you both for coming out and providing us with this information, because it sounds like a great weekend, 3-day event coming up in Hampton. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having us.
And we want to encourage you guys to go to HamptonCupRegatta.com and find out all the information August 10th through 12th. Come out and see us.